Hello, internet friends. My name is Bay. This is Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, but I'm bad. A light commentary playthrough, where I will play through the entire game slowly over time, in chunks or live. You choose if you want to watch it in chunks or live, up to you. We are going to clean the map before we move on, because that is how we will play this game. Oops. See you down there, bud. Another cosplay opportunity. Cannot flee from these battles.
Dangerous fiends may be in the vicinity. Exercise caution.
Pressure, stagger, and do not get poisoned.
Rare toxorat variant identified. Commencing guidance protocol. The pungent odor that these fiends release when threatened is so effective at driving away predators that their population has exploded.
Guess I got it.
Oh,
capable of spitting toxic fluids on its prey before attacking in mass. Such toxic
weak to frost.
After you.
Imagine something like that creeping into every corner of the fight, and you'll understand why they're considered such a menace.
Winter's come.
And luckily, the data we collect here will aid us in finding a way to reduce their numbers.
Defense here.
I'll show you what I can do.
Get him!
Okay.
Come on!
Go for it now.
I see you haven't completed your objectives for that battle. Well, you're always welcome to make another attempt.
Avoid being poisoned, so don't get meleeed.
Rare toxorat variant identified. Commencing guidance protocol. The pungent odor that
you sure you
don't overdo it.
Ready so when you are. Driving away predators, that their population has exploded. This particular variant is capable of spitting toxic fluids on its prey before attacking in mass.
Is that it?
Such tactics allow them to hunt creatures as large as alpha dogs. Imagine something like that creeping into every corner of the fight, and you'll understand why they're being considered effective. With any luck, the data we collect here will aid us in finding a way to reduce their numbers.
Going in, is that enough?
I believe in you!
turn you back.
All objectives completed. We've accrued a lot of great data, thanks to you.
This is a boss fight waiting to happen down here. Oh! Yes, it gets the pets. I know, the sign is not secured. What do you want me to do? It was supposed to give me like an arrow. A relative arrow. There we go. Little silly. Oh, I noticed that time it did say 2 rubies. Oh.
Hey, Cloud. Do you notice any sparkling minerals nearby?
Oh, yeah.
These are known as guide stones, crystals that direct travelers to shrines to the divine. The stones emit light when they shatter, producing an illuminated path. If ever you're lost, try smashing one. Following the light should lead you to a sanctuary set to honor the tutelary deity of a given region. The shrines contain untold divine knowledge, slumbering within massive crystals. I can use this knowledge to strengthen your summoning materia, so I encourage you to seek out said sanctuaries.
No.
The grasslands are home to Titan sanctuaries. In the Age of Myths, when Titan rose from his subterranean prison, he created a massive earthquake. Thus did a vast swath of land rise from the sea, becoming the grasslands.
Whoa. This is going to get a lot more detailed as I go on, I imagine. Definitely some leeway on that. These are gonna get much harder, I imagine. Yes?
Analysis complete. I managed to extract the necessary data from the crystal. This should allow me to strengthen your materia.
Huh. Neat. So cool, because you could see Midgar like that in the original game.
The proto relic should be somewhere in your vicinity. It may not be in plain sight, but I trust you'll be able to find it.
These would be like open world puzzles, I'm assuming.
Enough to intimidate the likes of...
No, please, it's all yours. Just don't hurt us again.
Play dead! Play dead! What you want? We're freaking out! Now listen here, numbnuts. I got a foolproof plan.
What?
I call it... Use a decoy!
Yeah!
Decoy. All of you, that's who. Gentlemen, it has been an honor. If you survive, meet back at the hideout.
Damn it, decoy's attack.
I got this.
Get him. That's it.
He's on now.
Impressive.
That's that. Now, here we go. Leave it to me.
Go on!
I got you. Oh. No, it's not.
Yeah.
You should have assessed early and forgot.
Best do it right.
Yeah, it's just fire weakness because they're just dudes. May have high potions, okay. Alright.
Let's get this over. Gotcha. Here we go.
Wrong button.
Won't last long.
Can't push him.
Dead. Super duper dead.
Dead.
Craftsman 5.
Now's our chance. Let's catch up with Beck.
Hey, wait for me.
Not Dark Souls. ATB ward. Or a thing for later. Or nothing.
No way, run. Damage.
me.
Right.
Copy.
I'll make it quick.
Give it your all.
Let me teach him a lesson. That's it. Let's get serious. We'll make it quick.
That'll do.
Sorry about that.
Go on!
Gotta go for it now. Got it, and we're safe.
All right, that counted. And the passive ATV gen is almost nothing. They have to be attacking. Party level 2. The little ones definitely look like Cloud, for sure. The Choco chicks. They have like a feathered mohawk going on. Well, that was 2-2-2, so maybe I think Cloud has to have the thing on. But I have to go check again. I put it back on Barret, for example. I mean, it's whatever right now, I guess.
We're in monster territory now.
Rare Alpha Dog variant identified. Commencing guidance protocol. The docile disposition of the Alpha Dome led to its widespread adoption as a beast of burden. Applications included agriculture, transportation, and even warfare. Variants like these, however, were valued as a source of hides and tusks used for arts and crafts. Unfortunately, they are a notoriously difficult creature to raise in captivity, and were usurped by the now ubiquitous Chocobo. At present, the only remaining wild Alpha Dogs can be found here, in the grasslands. Most are aggressive, especially these ones, which is why we must study them thoroughly, before they become a threat to both animals and humans. Currently gathering combat data on target.
That's it!
Wrong button.
It's on you.
Oh, it confirms there's level 3 limit breaks now. I don't know if that would be Omni Slash yet, but... in the little screen. Yeah, I only got one scan off. When they're talking in that one screen. Oh, this one can be scanned too? No. Oh, I can be later. they have like old Star Fox 64 mouths where they're just like. And Star Fox 64 mouths were like. But you get the idea. That barrel was rolling. Other items here? Huh? Do I do the slide again? Sick. That'll be needed in harder ones, I imagine. Found the name for the YouTube video. An excavator. I love it, but it still makes me groan. Stool.
That mushroom.
Okay. Uh-oh.
What the?
Welcome to our Moogle Emporium. Though, I'm sorry to say, we aren't open quite yet. And I'm not even sure when we will be. Those Mooglets are refusing to come back. And we can't do business without them, Koopo. Actually, maybe you wouldn't mind helping? The Mooplets are having too much fun to come back on their own, so I want you to round them up. And then we can open up the Emporium, and everyone will be happy, Kubo!
Fine. I'll see what I can do.
Thanks so much, Kubo!
Oh no. Oh no! Get hit 3 times and the game will end. That was a palm on his head. Is there another way to interact with them? Well, at least it's a real Moogle this time. I don't know if that's better or worse. Materia earrings allows use of the highest level of the HP up materia. Cloud's volume for now, and then I'm sure we'll get plenty more.
Koopa? Just so you know, there are 6 more mock stools out there, Koopa. So be sure to say hi to my friends if you find one. Also, the more emporiums we open up, the more stuff we'll have. have for you to buy. That's a win-win situation in my books, Koopo.
Something tells me that's not how their voices sounded in my head, but at the same time, sure.
Koopo!
Complete the stage to earn a Moogle medal. Oh, so you could just farm them? Do you get more if you do better?
Please bring back all the Mooglets for me, Koopo!
A weird little delay. There you go. Reflexes. That came out of left field, literally. That's from right field, I guess, but.
Thanks so much, Koopo!
I'm assuming the later ones may have challenges and things. Okay, I'm not gonna sit here and grind out Moogle medals. Not doing that. Maybe later if necessary, but not right now. That was a hint of something else around? No? Okay.
Sorry, but I gotta.
Did that count, or does she need us to do an offensive spell? Oh, it does say attacks. This is remake brain. It's attack spells. It is attack spells. Okay. It is attack spells. I already wanted this one earlier when I was just derping around there, didn't I? I guess not. The box might respawn. Oh, that is. There he is. Oh.
Take the lead. Won't go for it.
So is my turn?
Disappointing.
Help a girl out. That'll do. Try using it.
Now.
Ready? Beautiful. One more shot. Catch up. I think we're almost done. I like that, huh?
Like I said earlier, a lot of my random exploration was not necessary because the game essentially points you to do all this again, but yeah, it's your first time learning something new. Oops.
tampering data, I was able to locate an old Republic transmitter chip. This chip likely contains an exceptionally rare formula. I recommend searching for it.
Okay. Oh.
It's on you. Follow my lead.
You ready?
I'll take care of him. Hey! Busy? Okay. Sorry about that. Needs more magic. Help a girl out. Crushed him. Come on. Awesome. Get him.
You okay?
That's that. Go on! Here it comes! This one's for you!
Huh?
Hey, Cloud! It seems that a transmitter chip is buried nearby. You should be able to sniff it out with the aid of a chocobo. Once you pinpoint its location, you can ask your bird to dig it up. With that, let the treasure hunt begin!
Excavating? I've been doing okay. I thought it was something different. I guess there's just specific points for them. That's what that means. Cushion. I like how everyone else on their chocobo is actually doing the same thing, kind of. Through. Getting it? You have to manually do the sniffing yourself.
That's quite the transmuter chip you found. In fact, it was once used in the construction of windmills. Given its rarity, I would not be surprised if someone had need of such technology.
Okay. Okay, so it's just more concentrated. Gotcha. I see you.
Get him!
Keep it together.
Ready when
keep it together.
So it's my turn? That's it! One more shot!
Enough.
Let's get serious. Buckle up! A bonus!
Sorry about that.
So Chocobo Chick runs away when we were in combat? I break for chocobos. Increases HP, MP, strength, magic. Huh. I'll give it to Aerith, because it gives faith too, which is just magic up. Bravery is attack up. Faith is magic attack up. Seems pretty neat. That's what happened. I see. This part of the game definitely naturally loops you back right around to go to Calm, though. Because everything we're doing now will eventually end on this side of the map, and you have to go back to Calm. Basically, Tutorial Island. I respect it.
Together. All done.
There. Cloud's legs are broken.
Fiends, huh? Been itching for a fight.
Rare Mandragora variant identified. Commencing guidance protocol. It may look like nothing more than a wriggling plant, but don't be fooled. Mandragora roots are capable of functioning as legs, allowing them to actively pursue sunlit locations as they shift throughout the day. In case you didn't know, chocobos seem to adore feasting on the fiend's seeds. I can't help but wonder what this variant might taste like. Further research may prove beneficial to any chocobo-raising activities. So for the sake of your feathered friends, mow those Mandragoras down!
I got your number.
Inflicting enough damage will cause it to nap, but hitting with a powerful offensive ability will wake it up again. So I don't want to hit them that hard. So just auto-attack them down?
Leave it to me.
Get him! That was instant, so I don't know what caused it. Fire and ice, right?
It may look like nothing more than a wriggling plant, but don't be fooled. Mandragora roots are capable of functioning as legs.
Keep it together.
Allowing them to actively pursue sunlit locations as they shift throughout the day. In case you didn't know, chocobos seem to adore feasting on the fiend's seeds. I can't help but wonder what this variant might taste like. Further research may prove beneficial to any chocobo raising activities. So for the sake of your feathered friends, one more of those mandragoras.
That'll do. Here he comes. One more shot. Just a bit. This one's for you. One more shot.
Oh, I stagger with that.
Thank you.
Huh.
daily objectives, too.
How do you stagger something that if you hit it too hard, it sleeps? But also if you hit it too hard, you kill it before staggering it. Interesting. Hit it too hard, it sleeps. Hit it too hard, it dies. Have to hit it really hard for to pressure it.
Don't overdo it.
I'm very confused. I have to hit it really hard to pressure it to stagger it, but if I hit it really hard, it just dies.
Like what I thought it was. Okay.
Come on! Keep it up! Come on!
Okay, so it's one at a time, slow and steady. No major, no big attacks. Okay.
Congratulations! You managed to complete all intel objectives.
So don't pressure them because it does too much damage. Interesting. Different way to do it. Sure. Because if I was using magic to pressure, it does too much damage. So it would usually just kill them. Or they would go quick nap. All right. Crack owl, found it. Nope, I was thinking there's gonna be a fourth, but there's not. So cool. Oh, there's a squirrel one somewhere. I missed it. First strike materia. Gotta do these two. Auto unique and auto cast. What does Aerith do with auto unique though? Dude, copper bracelet goes hard. Looks like it's just two materia. Well, you can enhance it. What does it do? Oh, just more stats. Not a lot of XP though. Okay, well, thanks, game. Give away the goat a little bit on that one. I gotta fight Quetzalcoatl. Alright. It's a coattle. You know, kind of like roll that in. Level 5. Ah. Specifically, planet's favor. Which is probably next zone or the zone over or something. I suppose this is the way over, or is to get here? Is there a bridge here? This is through the swamps. We can't go through the swamps yet. Well, I guess we can now. But boss fight. So can I get here? Just through this, maybe? Definitely do the boss fight next episode, next part though.
This road's seen better days.
Much of the Republic's infrastructure has fallen into disrepair after years of neglect.
And you know damn well Shinra ain't about to spend a single gill on shit they don't use.
Is it true the Republic used to run buses between towns?
In other words, we gotta look at this.
I don't mind. I'm
not
exploring the green outdoors.
You do this. You're done.
That's it. Bring it.
So, how much HP is more? How are you gonna get your allies to not attack them if they're that low HP?
I could do that again.
Gonna be really low health. And then the AI is gonna keep auto-attacking. So
just using those shipping containers to cover your approach.
Oh.
Inconsolable.
Inconsolable? What's that?
Oh, it's like when you're consolable, but
I better be real bloody.
You think that Merc's gonna come after us?
Hope there's plenty to go around.
Right out here till that Merc gives up.
Hey, boss. Can we eat yet? We're hungry.
It ain't ready yet, dingus. We call it well done.
Smells
this
like
shit's
heaven.
Gotta get done well, not poorly.
Yeah, but I think you got it done too well.
Hey, are you a
I'm
chef?
Starving
you got
over
a puffy
here.
Hat?
No.
When
okay.
Do I?
Better we'll be hide out for here until that Merc gives up.
Hey, boss. Can we eat yet? We're hungry.
It ain't ready yet, dingus.
Get dingus.
We call it well done. Rare. This shit's gotta get done well, not poorly.
Yo.
If that's not well done, I don't know what is. Presenting the finest food
food you'll ever eat! Quick, black and bird!
You're the best, boss!
Turned out pretty good, if I do say so myself! Okay, boys, time to challenge!
So stupid.
This thing that bad, huh? Ain't in the talking mood, huh? Well, we sure as hell ain't gonna just hand it over.
I don't have time for this.
Right now, boss!
Relax, boys. I've got just the plan. I call it baiting the hook.
Yeah! Hook in the bait! So, what's the bait?
For all intensive purposes, it's you!
Me?
Here, take this!
Thanks! Can I eat it?
Tuck it for the getcha!
Ow! Down, eat me!
Don't hold back.
Go on!
Get ready.
Whoa.
Best do it right. I got your number.
Nothing to it. Go on!
You?
I most certainly can. Not only that, I've deduced where the bandits are headed next. And on that note, I'll let you get back to it.
That makes sense. Is every Proto Relic thing gonna be like this kind of like a mini game chase thing? I'm stuck. Oops. Whoa. I guess there might be one, because we, well, there's one way down there, but. Stuff. A good place to stop. We've got big snake and big weird bird thing to go after. If you've been watching live, appreciate you. Thank you very much. If you've been watching on YouTube, thank you as well. Of course, you can watch all this and the previous game and the DLC and Final Fantasy 16 and Dark Souls 1, 2, and 3 and Bloodborne and everywhere else if you want to go watch those too. We'll see you all in the next one.